Amen. How does my hair look? All three of them? I got my comb. I didn't get a chance to use it. A little bit on that side over there. I'll work on that. Am I on camera? Hey, is Becky gonna see this?
Yep.
I look off. Becky's my wife, she does inspect on me sometimes. Anyway. It's good to be back in house of the Lord. I'm glad Jesus loves us, amen. Nobody loves us like he does, ain't nobody like him.
Amen.
Amazing grace. Love somebody like me and all of us, amen.
Thank you, Lord.
All right. As the choir comes this morning, let's get us a hymn and turn to page 281. We'll sing the first and the last. First and the last. 281. Amen. Stand to your feet. I do feel like traveling on sometimes, amen.
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 All right.
I hope you don't get green.
No, you can't.
281, I think.
All right. Everybody ready? Okay. My heavenly home is bright and fair. I feel like traveling on. No pain nor death can enter there. I feel like traveling on. Yes, I feel like traveling on. I feel like traveling on. My heavenly home is bright and fair. I feel like traveling on. The Lord has been so good to me. I feel like traveling on. Until that blessed home I seek, I feel like traveling on. Yes, I feel like traveling on. I feel like traveling on. My heavenly home is bright and fair. I feel like traveling on. We're going to do something different this morning. Brother Bill, would you have a set of prayer?
Dear Heavenly Father, Lord, I just come to you this morning and bring the Lord Jesus Christ. Yes,
thank you, God.
Lord, I just thank you for your word.
Yes, God.
Lord, I thank you for your word.
Yes.
Lord, I just pray right now that you bind Satan.
Yes, praise God. Yes.
Cast him out.
Praise God.
He has no power here.
That's right. Yes.
Lord, I just pray for the choir as they bring the songs. Lord, I praise you. Pray for the man that brings the message.
Yes,
Lord,
God.
I just pray that you give him power to speak freely.
Praise God. Yes.
Lord, bring the message to these people.
Thank you, Father.
Yes.
Thank you,
Father. Lord, I thank you for the ones that are here.
Yes,
God. Yes. Thank you.
The ones that are faithful.
Lead us, God.
Yes, God.
And Lord, I know we all fall short sometimes. Yes. Time, Lord, yes. Stand there with open arms.
Yes, me too, God. Thank you, God.
Lord, I just pray that you fall upon this place.
Yes,
Lord,
yes,
Lord,
God.
Please do.
Need to be encouraged by it, God.
Feel hard.
We praise you, Father.
I just thank you and I praise you for all you've done and all you're going to do. Lord, in the holy name I pray.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord.
When you doing birds? You doing text? Yeah, that would have been great.
I'm sorry, that's my fault. 49.
I walk by the tomb of Buddha.
You can't do the right thing as far as works to get to heaven. It's not what you have, it's what you receive. You receive Christ as your Savior on this side of eternity. You've been born again, amen? There's no other way. Jesus said, I'm the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh to the Father but by me, amen? It's not religion, and I'm glad. Joe, I'd miss out. It's amazing grace. All right, let's all stand as the choir comes and turn around and shake somebody's hand and welcome this morning.
See, buddy. Hey. I'm like, hey, brother, how you doing?
Well, you've been hiding her, and she's been holding out on it.
I know. Got another one. What you want to see, buddy, for? You ain't gonna tell him good morning? You gonna tell him good morning?
Buddy, y'all been doing okay?
Yes, sir.
Hey,
see everybody this morning, amen. Good looking crowd, amen. Let me just say thank you for being here. And we still have some on vacation, and so we're praying for them to be back safe. And praying, and we have some that was out last week and are back with us. So thank you for being here. We got some visitors. Miss Cheryl's brought her family, one of her daughters, and her son-in-law and grandchildren. So I'm sure you got to go by and shake their hands. So good to have them. Make sure we make them feel welcome. And good to see all the smiling faces. Amen. Can I see a smile? Amen. Boy, that always brightens up the room, don't it? Amen. Let me have my ushers, if they will, to come, and we'll take up the offering and any prayer requests. I know we won't do just do uplifted hands. I know that we've all got a need in our lives and hearts that we need to pray about, and so let's pray for those. Amen. And I'm going to ask Ashton, if he will, to take us to the Lord in prayer. Amen, and bless the offering.
Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for this day. Thank you for letting us all come down here to this morning, Lord. And
yes.
Thank you for all you do. And thank you for the singing this morning, Lord. I feel it touched a lot of people's heart this morning, Lord. And just thank you for all you do. And let us all be safe, Lord. And just let us have a good rest of our day. And let us all be safe. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
All right. When the plate passes, you can be seated. Amen. And we'll take this time to give back to the Lord. And He's been faithful, and He's gave so much for us, and we thank Amen. You for that. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Amen. Hey, Michelle, can we get the song for the kids?
Yep.
Can we get that keyed up in a minute?
Yep.
And then we'll let them come around and give some dollars. Amen. We want to say thank you for those that tune in by Facebook. We do a live video on Sunday mornings. And I tell you one thing, this past week, our video last Sunday had over 750 views. Amen. So praise the Lord for that. And so I thank the Lord that He's using social media where you can get the gospel of the Lord Jesus out. And I've got so many missionary friends, and I've got one brother. He's over in Maui right now in Africa. He landed yesterday, Brother Leonardo, and I want you to pray for him and his team. He's over in Africa, and they've built churches. And I tell you, those children and those adults in Africa, he sent me videos, and they didn't have a place like this. They met in the open air. And they went and worshiped the Lord. But just last time that he was over there, he was able to build a structure and a church and build a place for the pastor and his family to stay. So you pray for that work in Africa. And then we've got missionaries in the Philippines, and let's continue to pray for them. And they're having a drought now, and so it's hard to find water. One of the brothers messaged me just a week or so ago and said they were having to go far away to find water and just to carry it back. So let's pray for Brother Eric and him. And then Brother Rio, we all pray for him. And there's just so much. And then Carrie White, this lady, she comes to my mind quite often. Miss Carrie, she tried to bargain with the Lord. Amen. How many of you know sometimes that don't work? Amen. But anyway, Carrie White is a missionary to the death in Africa. Amen. So you pray for her. She's been on the field now for almost 8 months. And so you pray for her and pray for her safety, because she's coming in contact with kids that are deaf and they just forgot about. And they don't really even know how to communicate with her through sign language. She's having to teach them sign language. And then, how many of you know, she tells them about Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. How many of you know everybody's important with God?
That's
Amen.
Right.
And so I thank the Lord for Miss Carrie White, and I thank God for what she's doing. And thank you, church, for supporting these missionaries. How many, Michelle?
10
missionaries. Give the Lord a hand, praise. Yeah. every month as they're out on the field doing the same thing that we're doing here in the state. So I thank the Lord, and I don't think we could, I tell you, it's just a blessing, amen. So you don't fail to pray for your missionaries, amen. All right, we're going to do the birthdays. Any birthdays? Did we have any birthdays this past week? We want to embarrass you real good and sing to you, amen. No birthdays. Okay, don't let you, we ain't going to let you slide, amen. If I get whipped, it's your birthday, we're going to sing to you. We're not going to embarrass you like that.
How many birthdays do you get a year?
I think it's one, Roger. Just one birthday. Sometimes Roger gets four or five, so we gotta watch him. I mean anniversaries. Any anniversary? There we go. We got an anniversary. Let's sing to him.
Happy anniversary to you. Happy anniversary to you. Happy anniversary. God bless you. Happy anniversary to you.
Amen. Give him a hand. Amen. Good looking hand. We're gonna do something a little different, Roger. We're gonna have our kids to come up now, and this is the ministry for the Pregnancy Resource Center, and Michelle's gonna key up the song, and we want you to put $1 or $2 or $5 or $10 in these children's hands, and let's come and put it in the can. Amen. Praise the Lord. Give the Lord a hand, praise. Amen. I think last year we raised pretty close to $3,000. Amen. So I tell you what a great work they do, and it's right here in our community. And you know, the greatest thing they do is they share the love of Christ. Amen. They share Christ with these ladies. That's what we love. Amen. That's the mission, ain't it? Amen. To share Jesus to the world. Amen. All right, who's singing, Roger? Okay. Amen. Miss Cheryl. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord.
This song was sung by a member of my church in Pennsylvania. I love this gentleman. He was my choir director when I first joined the church. His name was Sam Abraham, and yes, you guessed it, he was a Jewish man.
Amen.
And he considered himself a complete Jew because he accepted Christ as a Savior, went on to be a missionary for the Jews in Montreal, amen, Canada. So he since has gone to be with the Lord. So I hope you enjoy it. It's amen. Named El Shaddai, and it means God Almighty.
Yes, right? Amen. Praise the Lord.
El Shaddai, El Shaddai, El Elyona Adonai. Age to age, you're still the same by the power of the name. El Shaddai, El Shaddai, Erkam Kana Adonai. We will praise and lift you high, El Shaddai.
Amen. Yes.
Through your love and through the ram, you save the son of Abraham.
Yes.
Through the power of your hand, turn the sea into dry land.
Right.
To the outcast on her knees, the word of God who really sees. By your might, you set your children free.
Amen. Yes. Amen.
El Shaddai. El Yonah Adonai. Age to age, you're still the same. By the power of the name. El Shaddai. Ekam Kana Adonai, we will praise and lift you high, El Shaddai.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Through the years you've made it clear that the time of Christ was near, though the people couldn't see what Messiah ought to be. Through your word contained the plan, they just would not understand. Your most awesome work was done.
Yes.
Through the frailty of your son.
Amen.
El Shaddai.
Yes.
El Yonah Adonai. Age to age, you're still the same.
Mm.
By
Amen.
The power of the name.
Yes.
El Shaddai. Ekam Kana Adonai. We will praise and lift you high.
Amen.
El Shaddai.
Yes. Amen.
Saved and after, of course, and even now, what it was like to see that they thought the King of Israel was going to be Jesus Christ.
Mm.
He is the King.
Amen. Yes.
He's our King for all those that believe in Him. But some of the disciples were afraid to get near the cross. They saw it was the very end. Didn't quite understand. I think John, of course, and Luke understood. They were disciples. Amen.
Yeah.
But she couldn't quite figure out which one he was.
Yeah.
He was beaten so bad.
That's right.
Roman soldiers would beat him right in the face with their fists. The Sanhedrin soldiers would do the same thing. And, of course, the cat of nine tails just destroys the body. Crown of thorns on his head. So he was pretty much unrecognizable at the cross. There was an angry crowd there. And mocking him. And I know this. He says it's finished.
Amen.
Yes. Salvation has been paid for whosoever.
Yes.
If they Amen. Want it, they can get it.
Yes.
So just listen to the words of the song. How faithful are you? watching from a distance, and they could not take their eyes from you. You were bleeding, they were weeping, faithful sisters, they had followed you. They did not understand, they could not see, they were mourning their loss. As the sky turned black and the earth turned red at the foot of the cross, they were standing near your mother. They were so close, they could hear you sighing all around them. Angry voices pierced the darkness, and you were dying, but they would not leave. They lingered there, no matter the cost. They were staying, they were praying at the foot of the cross. Keep me near the cross, near the cross. May I never stray so far that I cannot see what flowed down for me at the foot of the cross. In your presence, and I cannot take my eyes from you. You have risen, why forgive me, precious Savior? Oh, I worship you. I'm not looking back, I've heard your voice. I'm staying. Now I kneel at the foot of the cross. Keep me near the cross, near the cross. May I never stray so far that I cannot see what flowed down for me at the foot of the cross.
Roger, praise the Lord. There's a message behind the song. Amen. Amen. Thank the Lord for that. Well, I love the old hymns, don't you? Amen. Nothing can beat the old hymns. Amen. We're going to ask the children now that they can go to children's church, and we'll have a ministry there. I think Ashley's going to take them back. So if you'll meet her at the back door, and then she'll be taking them to the fellowship hall. And then they always have a good time and always make something. So, amen. So you go and enjoy church. Amen. And I know you'll enjoy it and have a good time. Amen. All right. Praise the Lord. Amen. Amen. Thank you. If you will, turn your Bibles to Genesis chapter 22 while they're exiting. And I want us to take up on the message that we preached last week. And I want to kind of shift gears a little bit. We talked about faith makes a difference. And this week, I want to bring a message on faith brings about God's promises. Amen. How many of you love God's promises? Amen. I tell you, there's many in the Word of God. And there's many promises that God has promised us, and they're all ours if we have faith and believe in the Lord Jesus Christ and receive Him as our Lord and Savior. Genesis chapter 22, if you will, stand to your feet with me if you're able, and let's honor God's Word, and let's read just a few verses, and then there'll be many verses, but let's just read these to kind of take our text from, and we'll start in Genesis chapter 22 and verse 15. The Bible says, if you're into your Scofield Bible, that'll be page 33 in your Scofield Bible. Amen. Genesis chapter 22, verse 15. The Bible says, and the angel of the Lord called unto Abraham out of heaven the second time. Amen. When was the first time? Amen. Abraham had his son laid on the altar, had his hand stretched forth to slay his son. And the angel of God himself, stopped him. The second time, the angel of the Lord appeared and spoke unto Abraham, verse 16, and said, by myself have I sworn, saith the Lord, for because thou hast done this thing, and hast not withheld thy son, thine only son, that in blessing I will bless thee, and in multiplying I will multiply thy seed as the stars of heaven, and as the sand which is upon the seashore, and thy seed shall possess the gate of his enemies. And in thy seed shall all the nations of the earth be blessed. Say amen right there.
Amen.
Because thou hast obeyed my voice. So Abraham returned unto his young men, and they arose up and went together unto Beersheba, and Abraham dwelt at Beersheba. Let's pray together. Father, we love you. Father, thank you, Lord, for placing this upon my heart. And through the inspiration of the Holy Spirit, I want to be a blessing to you, Lord. God, I pray, hide me behind the cross and use me as your servant, God, today. And Lord, as we speak the message, Father, I pray, God, may it speak to our hearts. And may the Holy Spirit, God, do a work in our hearts and lives, Father. And Lord, we thank you for your promises, Father. Not only did God make a promise to Abraham, but he made an oath to Abraham. And God, I pray, help us, Lord, to expound on your word. And Father, we thank you and praise you in Jesus' name. Amen. All right, you can be seated. Praise the Lord. Thank God for the reading of his word. Amen. We thank the Lord. Last week, if you weren't here, we talked about the test that God tempted or put a test to Abraham, his only son, Isaac. He had another son, but this was the son that God had blessed him with when they were both of old age. And God tempted Abraham for a sacrifice to me. The Bible says they basically went a 3 days journey. Abraham rose up early the next morning and got things ready, and they went a 3 days journey. How many of you know Jesus was in the heart of the earth for 3 days? Yeah. I mean, I'll be knowing the third day he rose again.
Amen.
Amen. Could you imagine as Isaac looked to his dad that day as they were going up the mount? Abraham had already made a profound statement. He says that I and the lad are going yonder, but he says we will come again. So Abraham was really, his faith was really put to the test. But could you imagine Isaac, his son, the promised son that God had promised him with? God resurrected, amen, the womb of Sarah as she was old age. And Isaac looked over at his dad. And he said, Dad said, we have the fire and we have the wood. But he says, where is the sacrifice? And Abraham, by the eyes of faith, he looked into the eyes of his young son. And he says, son, God will provide himself a sacrifice. Amen. Amen. What a profound statement. Abraham had faith that God was going to come through. Even Hebrews 11 and verse 19, Michelle, if you can pull that up. Even if Abraham felt that even if he had to carry through on sacrificing his son, because he did, he had his hand stretched forth to slay his son. But the angel of God called him out. But look what Hebrews 19, accounting that God, here's what Abraham viewed by faith. That if he carried out that task, accounting that God was able to raise him up. Say amen right there.
Amen.
Amen. He knew one way or the other that he and his son was going to come back down that mountain together. Amen.
Amen.
Aren't you glad that God gave us his son, the Lord Jesus? Amen.
Amen.
What a perfect picture, Abraham and Isaac, of God and the Father. And we mentioned that as Abraham and Isaac was going up the mountain, on the one side, that there was a sacrifice coming up on the other side. Amen. There was a ram. The Bible says there was a ram caught in the thicket by his horns. I believe that ram was already there. Abraham didn't see it. But how many of you know God provided a sacrifice for him, for Abraham that day?
Amen.
But let's talk this morning about the promise. Since Abraham came through the test, what did Abraham promise him? Notice what he says here in the scripture that we just read. Faith brings about God's promises. Amen. Notice what he says in verse 18. He said, I will bless thee. In thy seed shall all the nations of the earth be blessed, because thou hast obeyed my voice. How many of you know obedience is better than sacrifice?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Obey the Lord. And sometimes we have a hard time doing that, don't we?
That's right.
Obeying the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Sometimes we want to do it our way.
That's right.
Guess what? That never works out, does it? Amen. Never works out. But notice what God here, we think about what happened here. God made a promise to Abraham. How many of you know God has made a promise to us? God made a promise. And this promise is what he is going to do. In other words, when God says, I promise, it's something that he is going to do when all conditions have been met. Amen. In other words, did you know that God has promised us a place called the New Jerusalem, the heaven? Amen. And we read about it in Revelations. But all things is not in place yet. But not only did God promise Abraham, but God made an oath with Abraham. You say, preacher, God made an oath. What does that mean? That means that he is ready to do it. Amen. How many of you know God's made an oath to us that he gave us his son, the Lord Jesus Christ?
That's right.
That if we believe on him with our heart and confess him, that he will save us.
Yep.
Amen. And how many of you know Hebrews 6? Let's turn there. Hebrews 6 and verses 13 through 18. I want to read these verses here. Hebrews chapter 6 and verses 13 through 18. Bible says in verse 13, when God made promise to Abraham, because he could swear by no greater, he swear by himself, saying, surely, blessing I will bless thee, and multiplying I will multiply thee. And so after he had patiently endured, he obtained the promise. They said in the next chapter, in Genesis chapter 23, that Sarah died. How many of you know Abraham had a burial place? He had put money on that. Amen. And it was the land of Canaan. Amen. That was the land that God had promised him. And he took Sarah and he laid her to rest there. But how many of you know that probably for 40 years say 40 years with me. 40 years. Isaac was able to enjoy his mother.
Amen.
Say amen right there. Amen. 4 decades he was able to be raised and be nurtured by his mother and have fellowship. What a great promise that was. But one day, his mother passed. While Isaac was in grieving, how many of you know Abraham in Genesis chapter 24 had a servant named Eliezer? Amen. Say Eliezer for me. Amen.
Eliezer.
Amen. You can pronounce those words. There you go. I love Eliezer. He was a servant of Abraham. And he told Eliezer, he said, put your hand under my thigh, and I want you to swear by the oath that you'll go and you'll find a bride for my son Isaac. Amen. Hallelujah. How many of you know God is in search of a bride for his son today, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. And I'll just paraphrase the story a little bit. But Eliezer, he said, well, says he said, God, just give me a sign, because he struggled with it. And let me just say this before I say that, that Abraham had been in this situation with his nephew Lot before. Well, he didn't want to make that mistake again and leave him on his own to search out a land. Because how many of you know that didn't work out too good? He chose Sodom. Amen. And he had to, and Sodom was destroyed. And so the land of Sodom was destroyed. So Abraham knew that it had to be different for Isaac. So he sent Eliezer. Could you imagine that Isaac never saw his bride? They never dated. Okay, Mom and Dad, here's what we're going to do. We're going to go search a bride or a groom out for our children. Amen. But you think about it. Abraham was on, Eliezer was on search for a bride, and it had to be of his kindred. Had to be of his kindred. Amen. So Eliezer said, well, said, I'm going to go to the well, and I'm going to draw water. But if she asks for my camels to drink, and how many of you know a camel can drink about 24 gallons of water, just one of them, amen? And he says, then that'll be a sign. Sure enough, they were at the well, and here come a beautiful lady named Rebecca come to the well. Guess what? She asked for him a drink, but then she asked for the camels to drink. And the story goes on. He goes back to her house. And sure enough, this daughter is of his kindred. Amen. How many of you know Abraham wanted to protect Isaac from picking a pagan bride? Amen. How many of you know there's nothing good in the world for you and I as a believer?
Right.
Amen. The Bible says, come out from among those things, saith the Lord. Amen. Touch not those unclean things. Amen. Did you know that when God saves us, that he cleans us up? Amen.
Amen.
Ain't that good? He cleans us up. I mean, he takes all those sins and he throws them into the depths of the sea to remember them no more. What a beautiful picture. In Genesis chapter 24, and all the time, God is working a promise through Isaac. He is working the promise that he had promised Abraham through his son Isaac. And he takes, and the Bible says that Isaac is on his camel, and he sees a lady coming, and she's got a veil. And you know what? Isaac is grieving the death of his mother. And he looks and he sees the bride. The Bible says that he lit off the camel and he met his bride. How many of you know one day the Bible says that Jesus is coming in a moment and a twinkling of an eye?
Yep.
Amen. You know what? Did you know he's in search of a bride today?
Amen.
And he'll make that bride without spot and without blemish.
Yeah, that's right.
Did you know that God was carrying his promise and his oath out, but God used Eliezer? Eliezer is a type of the Holy Spirit. How does God search out a bride today? Through the Holy Spirit of God. Amen. Amen. Only the Holy Spirit. Unless you are drawn by the Spirit, you're in no wise. You can receive him, not receive him. But Eliezer was a type of the Holy Spirit. And could you imagine somebody that Isaac had never seen? I believe she was the most beautiful woman that he had ever seen. Guess what? Because that's who God chose for him. Amen. That's who God chose for him. You know, you think about this. I've never seen God, and I've never seen Jesus. Amen. But through the eyes of the Spirit, sometimes I think I can see him. Amen.
Yeah.
But ain't it wonderful that one day, hallelujah, that one day, like Isaac laid his eyes on Rebekah, we're going to lay our eyes on our precious Savior, the Lamb of God.
Amen.
The one that went to the cross and gave his life for us. The one that became sin for us, who knew no sin, that we might be made the righteousness of God in him. Let me tell you, friends, you say, well, preacher, I just can't put all this together. Did you know just this week and last week, you know, I've run across people that really, they just really deny the existence of God. They deny the existence of God. I mean, you know, I struggle with that. But it says the natural man receiveth not the spiritual things of God, for they are spiritually discerned. I'm going to tell you one thing that Satan is fighting all across our nation today, and that's creation. I'm going to tell you what, friends, God made me. Amen.
Man.
God made man. He made male and female. Say
that's
amen right there.
Amen.
Right. Amen.
Yeah,
and they were
on.
Adam, not Steve, but Eve.
That's
amen.
Right. Yeah,
they
on.
Were Adam and Eve. Amen. Hallelujah. I mean, friends, we got a generation coming up red blue. They don't know what they want to be. I'm talking about that's a messed up generation. Amen.
Yeah, come on.
That's a messed up generation. Because God either made you male or he made you female.
That's right.
But you see, that's the enemy. Satan is working. He's working. He wants to destroy all of us. Amen. But Isaac laid his eyes on Rebekah, and she was perfect. That was just what God had for him.
Amen.
I tell you what, I'm not perfect today. And you are not either. Amen. Say amen right there.
Amen.
The Bible says if we say that we have no sin, then we deceive ourselves.
That's right.
And the truth is not in us. And I'm not giving us a license to sin by no means. But I'm not perfect. But I tell you what, friends. One day when I get to glory, hallelujah, I'm going to be perfect.
Amen.
I'm going to be just like Jesus.
Yes.
Boy, God said that the old things is going to pass away. And I'm going to have a glorified body. Amen. Because
yes.
I couldn't look at Jesus in these eyes. But we're going to be just like him. Amen. Ain't that amazing?
Amen.
But God is working a promise through Abraham. How many of you know he's doing it even today?
Yep.
How many of you know we're sons and daughters of Abraham?
Yeah.
Of that seed.
Yep.
Today.
Amen.
That lineage. Amen. I could go on and on. Listen, Isaac has two sons. What were his sons? Jacob and Esau. And you know the story of Jacob and Esau. Guess what come out of Jacob? Was it not the 12 tribes of Israel? Yes, it was. The nation of Israel that God had promised. Joshua led the children of Israel after being in bondage in Egypt. Where? To the Canaan land. God promised Abraham that land. And God let it come to pass. Think about this. Jacob had 12 sons. And there was one of his sons that he loved. And he made a coat of many colors. His name was Joseph. Did you know that Joseph in the book of Genesis was a perfect type of Christ? He was sold into slavery. Amen. Jesus became sin for us, whom you know sin. Jesus wasn't guilty of anything but loving a sinner, loving somebody like me. But yet he was falsely accused. Joseph was stowed in the dungeon. But you know, listen, God was working his plan through Abraham. Because guess what happened? There was a drought in the land. Guess where Joseph just happened to be? He was in Egypt. Remember Potiphar? He was the second in command, and he found favor with Joseph. Guess what Potiphar's wife did? Lied on Joseph. Guess what happened to Joseph? Was he thrown in prison? He was stowed in prison. But guess what God did? He found favor with God in the prison. Amen. Right. Because Pharaoh had sent a baker and a butler to prison. Amen. And just not by chance. Amen. How many other things ain't by chance? Amen. Right. Amen. But God is in total control of the situation. The children of Israel could have been wiped out because of the drought. But yet, God had Joseph to interpret a dream for Pharaoh, and he was second in command in Egypt. Amen. Ain't that good? You know what I'm talking about? Amen.
Yep.
He was second in command in Egypt. And guess what? His brothers, just not by chance, brought their sacks over to Egypt to get corn. Well, they didn't recognize Joseph, but Joseph recognized them. Where did the children of Israel end up in? In the land of Egypt. Not by chance. But God saved the people. God was working his promise through Abraham, through Isaac, through Jacob, and now through Joseph. And he saved his family. You know what he did? What did he do? He put the money back in their bag, did he not? He put the money. And then Joseph moved his family to Egypt. And his family was saved from the drought. Now, later, that turned not so good. But how many of you know there was a man by the name of Moses that God raised up? There was a decree that had been made over Egypt that the firstborn of the male would be what? Be cast into the Nile River and to be done away with. But Moses' mother said, he's a goodly child. No, he was a promised child. Amen. He was a deliverer for the children of Israel. Amen. And you could just go on and on. But he says, he told Abraham, he says, that your seed would be as the stars of the sky and the sand of the sea. And then there was David. And then there came Jesus, the Messiah, the Lamb of God. Let me read in Hebrews, and we're going to close here. Hebrews 13, in verse 14, he says, saying, surely, blessing I will bless thee, and multiplying I will multiply thee. So after he had patiently endured, he obtained the promise. How many of you know it ain't going to be easy? Amen. It's not easy to live a Christian life. But look, friends, we're going to receive the promise by faith. How many of you know without faith it is impossible to please God?
That's right.
Say amen right there.
Amen.
It's impossible. And so after he patiently endured, he obtained the promise. For men verily swear by the greater, and an oath for confirmation is to them an end of all strife, wherein God willingly more abundantly to show unto the heirs of promise the immutable of his counsel confirmed it by an oath. Listen, that by two immutable things, listen to me, friends, if you don't hear anything else I've said today, listen to this. In which it was impossible for God to lie. Say amen.
Amen.
Amen. That we might have a strong consolation who have fled for refuge to lay hold upon the hope set before us. Which hope we have, this in verse 19, which hope we have as an anchor of the soul. both sure and steadfast, which entereth into that within the veil. Whether the forerunner is for us entered, even Jesus, made a high priest forever after the order of Melchizedek. Thank God for Jesus. Amen. God gave us His Son. He gave heaven's beds for us. And that was a promise in the Old Testament that the Messiah would come. And His very own people rejected Him. But thank God, not only was it to the Jew, but it was also to the Greek, to the barbarians, and to the Gentiles. Thank God for that. Amen. Thank God for His promise. And I highlighted another verse that I wanted us to look at. One day, you and I is going to stand before God.
Yeah.
Amen. We're going to stand before God. It'll be two places. It'll be either at the white throne judgment, the great white throne judgment, and that's for sinners. That's for those that have not received Jesus. And the Bible says that you will be judged according to your works. If you had heard the gospel and rejected the gospel, the Bible says that you'd be bound hand and foot and be cast into the lake of fire that burns with fire and brimstone. And He said, this is the second death. Or you'll stand before God at the judgment seat of Christ. Say hallelujah right there. Because that's for us. That's for Christians. But listen, friends, a very sobering fact that we are going to stand before God at the judgment seat of Christ as Christians, because our names are found written in the Lamb's Book of Life. And if your name was not found written in the Book of Life, then you were cast out. Amen. But if it was found written in the Lamb's Book of Life, you and I will give an account of our stewardship, basically how we lived out our Christian life. Were we faithful to God or were we not faithful? But let me say, friends, in the end, you and I will receive the promise of what? Eternal life with Him in heaven. Amen. Ain't that good?
Amen.
But notice this verse here, Hebrews 6 and verse 10. And I had another verse to read, but we don't have time to read it. But listen to this verse, because I figured it would kind of sum what I was talking about up. It says, for God is not unrighteous to forget. You see that word, forget? Your work and labor of love, which you have showed toward His name, and that you have ministered to the saints and do minister. We were talking about that a little bit in Sunday school, how that sometimes people, they want recognition for what they do. Say amen right there. But how many of you know that I believe God was talking about those that do things that's unnoticed. Amen. That do things that's unnoticed. How many of you know when we stand before Him, He'll bring them to light?
Amen.
He's not unrighteous to forget our labor of love. Amen. Let's all stand this morning. Have you received the promise? Like Abraham did. Have you received the promise? Let me say, friends, that if God said it, then we can mark it down. It's true. Amen. How many of you know the Word of God is inspired by Him?
Amen.
Holy men of God wrote as they were moved by the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
This Word is infallible. The Word, we said last week, it's the best seller and it's the most stolen book in all the world. Amen. Mm-hmm. I tell you what, this book is alive forevermore. It's alive. And I'm going to tell you what, friends, it will change your life. Let me say this morning, you're either on that broad road that leads to destruction, or you're on that narrow road that leads to life. And Jesus said, if you be there that find it. There's two ways today. I used to think, Roger, when I was growing up before I met Jesus, that if my good outweighed my bad, then I would be okay if I did enough good. Well, I read a scripture that says, there is none righteous, no, not one. For all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. You know what? That blew that out of the water. Because I'm not good enough. But I am through Jesus. Amen. Every head bowed and every eye closed this morning. Let me just be personal with you this morning. Let me ask you a question. Have you received Jesus in your heart? Does Jesus live in your heart? That's only by one way, and that's by faith through the Lord Jesus Christ. Say, yes, preacher, I'm saved. Would you do something? Just slip your hand up and write back down so I can see. Thank you. Praise the Lord. I wonder if there'd be somebody, and that was most of the hands. I wonder if there'd be somebody and say, preacher, I haven't done that. I'm not saved. I've never asked Jesus in my heart. I wonder, would you lift your hand up for prayer this morning? Say, preacher, I've not done that, but will you pray for me? I'm not coming to you. I won't embarrass you, but I just want to know who you are so I can pray for you. Would there be one? This morning, here's the altar call this morning. First of all, if you need Jesus, come. Come to Him. Jesus says, come, and I will in no wise cast you out. Let me say, friends, Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. Thomas said, how do we know the way? And Jesus says, I am the way. Friends, there's no other way. It's only through the Lord Jesus. Thank you for being personal with me there. This morning, how close are you with God? You say, preacher, I've just drifted away. Then I pray that you will come back. 1 John 1:9 says, if we would confess our sins, He is faithful and just to forgive us of our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. I tell you what we're going to do. We're going to open the altar up right now. Buddy's going to play a song of invitation. And if you need to come to the altar, you come this morning. This is your invitation. You need to come and pray. You need somebody to pray with you, then you come. And we'll have somebody to pray with you. Just let me know. We got some coming. Just slip out. I really believe we're living in the last days. And I tell you what, Paul told Timothy to fight as a good soldier of the Lord Jesus Christ. Be a good soldier, fight. We got to have the endurance in you. It's going to get tough. It's going to get hard. How many of you know there's a promise that God has promised us? Amen. You come. Thank you. Amen. Praise the Lord. All right. Amen. You love the Lord, say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank Him for His Word. Thank God for His promises. Amen. I don't know. Somebody tried to count them one time and said they were over 700, 800. I don't know. There's a lot. Amen. But aren't you glad for His promises? Amen.
Amen.
You know, I'm glad He said, I'll never leave you. I'll never forsake you. Amen. So thankful for that. Let me just say this. No evening service tonight. Okay.
Oh, okay.
No evening service. So take it away and you do the announcements. Amen.
All right, so disregard the choir practice and Bible study tonight. No service tonight. But if you have a prayer request, we have cards up front. Fill out the card, put it in the box. Prayer warriors will pray for those on Wednesday nights. We have the missions jar up front. Anything you put in that jar supports the 10 missionaries that we have. The 18th of this month is our monthly meal. During our monthly meal, we're going to be celebrating Preacher Gary's birthday. So be sure to come out, celebrate him, show him how much you love him. And then on September 18th is the Walk for Life. So all the money that the kids bring up here for the milk can, all that is collected, and it will go toward the Pregnancy Resource Center's Walk for Life. However, if you feel like, you know, giving money other than the milk can money, you're more than welcome to do that. Just give it to me, and I'll be sure to, you know, get it turned into Walk for Life. And if you're interested in walking, let me know, so that way I can get you signed up. I think registration opens on August the 11th. And then lastly, the item we're collecting for Operation Christmas Child this month is crayons. So we probably have over 40 boxes right now, but our goal is 200. If you can help us out with that, we greatly appreciate it. Walmart has them on sale right now for 50 cents a box for the Crayola brand.
Amen. Praise the Lord. I picked up a few last night. Amen.
Amen.
50 cents for Crayola. That's a good deal. Amen.
Yeah.
So let's make sure we meet that goal. Amen. Let's do something. If you got the offering, we got a need, and I want to take up a love offering. So you pray about what you can give, and we'll pray, and we'll let the Lord work for that. But you have to draft somebody to take. Okay, all right, there you go. Amen. All right, we. So we thank you for being faithful and giving, and I know it's greatly appreciated, and we do it out of our heart for God. And I tell you what, I love this church. This is a giving church, amen. And we try to help those that are struggling, and but anyway, I thank you for your faithfulness and giving, and thank you for that. Amen. All right. Praise the Lord. Let's get ready to close in prayer. Let me just say, let's pray for the preacher. He's just not having a good day today, so he's not here with us. So let's be lifting him up in prayer. And then not only him, but let's pray for Cindy as well.
Amen.
She's a caregiver now with him. And I think Roger went, and I think they got the ramp fixed. So we can, thank you for that, brother. Just send a text or call Cindy, and just let them know that you're thinking about them. And she went ahead and slipped out early so she could be by him and by his side today. So, but I believe in miracles, don't you?
Amen.
I know they've said they're going to start some type of therapy maybe for him. And I know God's able.
Amen. Amen.
I believe God still has things for him to do. Amen. So let's pray for him. And thank you for our visitors here today. Amen. Cheryl, good to see your family with us. And come back and be with us. Thank you for being here as members. Amen. Being faithful. Let's just pray for one another and lift each other up. Amen. We're living in dark times. And we need one another. Amen. The Bible says that the church is made up of many members. But how many of you know they all fit together jointly? Amen. I can't do plumbing like Larry can, but Larry can do plumbing, can't he? Amen. And not everybody can preach. He got a big clap out of that. But anyway, no. And I know that, you know, God has blessed us. And, I mean, we got some great cooks in this church. We got some great tea makers. Amen. Alvin and Mary Lou, boy, they can make some awesome tea. Amen. But anyway, I could just go on and on. I'm not going to point anybody out. Chocolate pies, amen. And she knows who that is, amen. But God is good. So thank you for being here. Be faithful to your church. Thank you for being here. And let's pray for one another. Amen. Amen. All right. Larry, would you close us out in prayer? Yes, God.